Hello, bros, and welcome to SFX Zero, Brofi Productions, and the next part of Minecraft Lord of the Rings mod. Oh, let's just dump all of wood away because we don't need more of this type of wood at least. But I do plan to grab that. Probably the dark wood farm, probably the most unreliable of all of them to not create enough saplings. But they do produce less saplings considering they're connected, but when you have a wood cutting mod it doesn't matter really. Start making alcohol. Well, he do seem to be trying to figure it out. Don't worry, enough work and you'll figure it out. Is he regular just at stock? Don't seem to be too inclined in doing alcohol. But he shouldn't be stuck. It should be just fine moving. I don't know what he was doing, but he's certainly not gonna stay around like that without actually putting in the work for it. come on. You can't put that there. When are they gonna fix that in Minecraft? I don't know what happened there. Oh, stop it. Stop placing them like upside down. You're still placing it the same way. What the hell? What the fuck? Oh, come on! Built a brewery. I'm probably gonna build a living house here. My house is still the dominant one. Maybe I should make a pond or some kind of way. That's so I can make a fisherman's place. As of right now, fisherman isn't something I can make for as long as this is. If I make a small lake somewhere and just connect it out to the sea, that does seem like a validated point. Tell me, if Sauron would try to take over the only surviving Palantir Tower, which is not done yet, that is what I'm building, the orcs would after that technically try to get across the bridge, getting past two gateways to get here. But getting past the two gateways isn't actually what's going to be hardest for them. It's actually when they get here, because then they face off against me, which is the thing that's gonna annihilate them all. I mean, I don't doubt I can take down an army of orcs in a game. In reality, that would take a little more time than it would take in the game. Not half bad with a sword, actually. I do own an old-looking Viking sword and a katana. So I do technically have what I would need to defend myself if I have any altercations. Gonna need more emeralds. Block of quartz, quartz pillar. Block of quartz, quartz pillar. The funny thing is, if I was in Hermitcraft, there would be so many secrets around my base that it would. That people that would actually explore the world after it was finished that season, I mean, they would not find everything. There is no way. My sugarcane farm. I made the same farm in Vault Hunters, but I made it completely covered up instead, and I only made 7 because I didn't have enough resources to make more. Resources actually is an issue for me in Vault Hunters. Resources usually ain't an issue for me, no matter what. If I turn this into brick, Yeah, it's a, so one stack is one stack, so it's equivalent to that. Let's go to build a little bit on a Palantir tower. We can honestly say it's a mega build, because in sheer size and also in how long it's gonna take. Cause building with quartz this much, well, it's not a thing you would actually most likely do in in most cases. Funny thing is, I always have command on when I play Minecraft, but I never really use them. Unless I have to, or unless something strange happens. Just to get me up. Actually, let me check one thing here. The gateway into the tower kind of is a little around halfway up one side. is gonna be a little menacing when I'm getting it done, but it does look correct, at least. I have a lot more quartz pillars than I need right now. Still, I've not figured out really how I'm gonna do with this chest plate. I mean, it is a validated thing to work on, I suppose. Aqua Affinity, I will technically the bouncy, double flame way, frostwater looting. Why is it looting on an armor? Pockets. I need shulker shells for that. Oh god. Shield strap. At one offhand slot per level, allowing swapping the offhand item by interacting the news. I mean, it's not that bad. Snowdrift strip. Spilling tool belt on arm. Tool belt? That. Allows swapping the first 4 hotbar slots using the leggings interact. Second level allows swapping for 8 hotbar slots. Also apply pocket chain to get all 9 slots. On the tab, allows applying modifiers to boost the damage of an empty hand. Allows punching with the offhand. What? Actually, you can apply that to an elytra, which is interesting. That might actually work out in beneficial ways in the future. Sumo wouldn't really help me. Double jump could work well sometimes. Allows you to jump a second time in mid-air. Higher levels an additional jump, allowing the triple jump to potentially even quadruple jump. piston and phantom membrane and a sky slime block. Do I have sky slime blocks in this? I'm trying to access the chest! Congeal sky slime block. That's not right. Oh. There's a lot of strange things. I got 36 on me. I don't need sticks. It is effective for secret storage. I mean, these barrels can be constructed in any world. I just prefer to use the half slabs side to do it, but I mean you can use full blocks. Of course it means you have a little less space inside, but it doesn't really change how much you can fit inside it. How many coal blocks do I have? Let's sleep so we don't get attacked by phantom if we go to the top of this. If I have too many coal ore, then we change it to make something else. Okay, 37 here would mean 219. See if my quick math is correct. Probably not. I'd say quick math isn't really my strong suit. But I was correct. In Vault Hunters, I have a chest full of villagers. That's a weird sentence in this game. I do actually have a chest full of villagers, so... Well... A little funny. You don't want coal, you don't either want coal. Do you want coal? No, you want strength. You won't come up. Aha! The fishermen's cooperating for once. Campfires? You can buy campfires from fishermen? I'm gonna buy a campfire from you and set you on fire. Fishing rod without breaking, or I can sell the raw salmon and to him. I'm not gonna buy fish from you. I don't trust you. That fish looks fishy. And it's actually true. The fish looks fishy. After all, it is a fish. Fish doesn't look fishy, so they you start to have to wonder. How does the alcohol producing go? They have not figured it out yet. I mean, I didn't figure it out instantly either. I just tried a few things until it worked. But I managed to make vodka. So, yeah. Drinking alcohol that is produced from Lord of the Rings mod doesn't have any benefits. lot of card. Lots and lots of card. I think they're gonna buy fish from one of the fishermen and I'm gonna just release them back out into the sea. Five clownfish for one emerald. That's not that bad. Still bad, but not that bad. Let's free the fishes for some reason. Finish the end. Not done. Get an elytra. Not done. Create a mega base. Well, it is in the making. Make a ME room. That are done. Go to Middle Earth. Not done. Create a guardian farm. It's in the creation. Create an underwater base. It's in. Well, I'm still trying to figure out really how to do it. Make a wolf pen. Yeah, I need that. Get the wither skulls. I done that. And kill the wither. Improve village. I done that a lot in this episode. Last episode. I mean, we do have a blacksmith. We do have a library, we do have a stonemason's workspace, and we do have a brewery. Let's see if they have the start to figure this out. All of them is empty. They're never gonna figure that out. I believe. What is that guy over there doing? Doesn't he have a home? Is there a problem? The iron golems are reproducing at an alarming speed right now. I wanted a bounty hunter to kill all the iron golems, this is where you should go. Black market. I still need a new bow. Don't you even try. The bow didn't do too much, but the spear finished it. There's too many iron golems. Well, let's do it the smart way, I suppose. Or it might be the stupid way. That depends! Don't worry, I'm just taking the iron golems for a walk. They look like they need the exercise. You coming with me? Thank you. There, cleared out all the iron golems. Let's see if we got any leads left. We don't lose too many. We did have 19 from the beginning, didn't we? I soon need a new bow. And this is a flimsy elven bow, so next bow I suppose I'm gonna make improved elven bow. Or should we make it, call it an elven bow and go for improved elven bow after that? I don't know. You never know these things. Or when I'm involved. I mean, when I'm involved, anything can happen, really. Two sticks and one piece of iron. If my calculations are correct, but I don't know. I don't think. Is it possible to do that? I would like to try it. This can, if I can do this, it would help me a bit. Yeah, don't work. I could place two item frames on the same. I could put a spear behind it so it's clear that it's what it's used for. How is the turtles doing? They're doing fine. Transported or moved to the appropriate place for usage. Where is this trading hall? I mean, they're not serving any real purpose otherwise. I mean, iron is important in the beginning, but after you get into a certain point along a normal Minecraft playing, it is kind of useless, but trading with it is always useful. Could at least let you buy 16 instead of 12. not mourning the wheel just yet. Look at this. Even though you live in these cubicles, or whatever you want to call them, there is worse lives out there. Trust me, I can put you in those lives. What pricks? Actually, I need to put the iron here because I don't need it on me. I'm gonna buy the pillars. Oh, I can buy more. Thank you. Let's see. If I go as far as to make all my stacks 11. Well, it's a step forward, I think. But the fact that we still need more pillars is apparent now. That was the whole point, pretty much. And to actually farm quartz in the nether, both for pillars and for bricks, now is very obvious not an option. I mean, that was several stacks of pillars that we have used, and it wasn't enough to even do one roundabout with 11 in each to add to each one. Which means we're gonna need a lot more. Surprisingly, my boots aren't hurt. Everything else is hurt, but not my boots. And my boots is the ones that should have taken most damage there. Still no damage to them. How sturdy is my boots, actually? I'm gonna trade a little bit with the Loomers. I can buy lime green beds. Yellow dye. What do you make that from? What was the name? I don't remember the names. That are uncalculated for what they actually should do. I just put that. It's like a trash box nearly. I do have a lot of string. How does this box work? Not even one row. Wait. Uh-huh. melon fillet. Emeralds. Let's just see if we can clean this out a little. Some more emerald, that's paper, that's a saddle. That's more saddles. More paper, some kelp, some charcoal, some normal coal, stick. That's a little bit more coal. Alright, so put that in there. And put that in there. We do have a paper box, which is right here. We do have a salad box there. And coal goes in there. The charcoal, considering we have 10, we can split them up with putting 1 5 stack there and 1 5 stack here. And checking that box, which is empty. Okay, how much sand do I have? Actually, I do wonder if I just teleport here. Saves me travel time. I hate that. You are not allowed. I deny your desires. Mostly because the desire is to hurt me. Actually, if I could fill this with sand, I could do a lot. always think I'm gonna always manage to press wrong there. Let's collect some sand. Oh yeah, I'm not gonna be able to do that for a little while. Actually, considering that, teleport here. I got my bucket. And now teleport here and drink my bucket. That works out. Why do I have a stick on me? I mean, it's a sticker situation to have a stick. I should stop with those extremely bad puns. You know what, rabbit? That's a surprise. I wasn't expecting to be able to kill it by just smacking it with a shovel. That was not my intentions. My intention was to scare it and hurt it a little bit, not to kill it. Instead of having to swim back and forth, this saves some time. is gonna be when I actually get down to the temple later, when I actually done all of the layers outside, because then when I mining down to try to flatten this area out so I can make a proper farm from it, that's gonna be the hard part. Because the water is still gonna be inside the temple, which means I'm gonna have to clear that out some ways too. But I could go Elder Guardian farming and just leave one area like with water where the Elder Guardians do spawn. Just figure out how long time it takes for it to spawn back in. And just kill it again and again and again and get the sponges. I do want to get a sponge farm actually, but I'm gonna have to mark out where the Elder Guardian spawning rooms are to actually try to make that. How I'm gonna make it? I have not figured that out yet. But does Elder Guardian needs something to spawn on, or can you just like put out signs to block off the water flow so that it spawns in the water and then when it goes down it's kind of just falls into a killing chamber? But if that works, that would be a farm. Not how I intend to do the guardian farm for the other ones, but it would work for the Elder Guardian. But I've never seen any kind of Elder Guardians farm. I don't even know if there are Elder Guardians. I don't know if that's their name. Well, the big guys. That gives me mining fatigue. I call them Elder Guardians because that's how I feel like they are. Guardians are killing the squids. Thought they were attacking me first, but apparently not. They don't like squids. They feel like they is invading their personal space. Which they technically are. I mean, the temple is the guardian's space. And the squids should not be here, technically. What the? I can't even touch you. I want to try that again. I'm always in for more playing. What do you think you're doing? Want to try again? Huh? Huh? Yeah, I need my cow. But at least I should be able to bring it over there without any problems whatsoever. The guardian should not be able to target my cow now when I have secured this area to this extent. Okay, cowie. Thank you very much for the milk. I'm gonna take another bucket with me. Whoops. Oh. My shovel broke. Teleport here. Alright, so repair my shovel. And put a little more durability on the hammer. I need to go specifically mining for ancient debris soon. Oh, come on! See, this is one thing that I knew I would run into, which is a problem. See? Water. There's water here. Should be a guardian nearby also. Hey, wait. Is this like an outer layer that's not inhabited by any kind of guardian? Okay, there are. But why aren't any in that direction then? Oh, I see. I think. Maybe I don't. You never know! I don't like the sound in here. Need some air. Oh, there. Breed. Breeding is such an unnecessary thing in life. Think about it. If you didn't have to breed, you would have so much more time for other things that is much more useless. damn it. We need to be higher to get up there. Fatigued right now, so I need to get more milk. Technically, I think I'm gonna keep on going as going there. Go in the temple, clear out area after area of water, and then we can do everything, all the rest from the top. Where did you come from? Alright. Let's TP home by using the minimap. Got a little bit of prismarine stuff. Dark prismarine is the rarest, but I do believe you can make that later on. Gold rabbit's head. I think a rabbit's head is a fitting price. It means I managed to handle a raid. Do I have any other heads that I would say is a fitting price? Aggravated Vex head is better price, would I say. And I do mean the red Vex heads than those that are red in the face and such. Because I have actually gotten one of those ones by accident in an earlier version of Minecraft. And I do believe I had the mod installed. But at least I do believe I'm gonna end it here because it's just a couple of minutes left until I'm gonna end it. I can't guarantee for sure, but I might trade with the villagers a little off screen to try to get more quartz blocks. So, at least that was all I have for this time. So, hit like and subscribe. See you next time. Profile.